issues that are destroying the white community from inside are not getting any kind of attention because of this radical shift of only, it's only brothers messing up.
Oh, yeah.
It's only black folks who do
that. Well, John McClane, you know, my book, I said John McClane, they have CNN.
Right.
The only difference between him and Jimmy Slacker is that Slacker was hanging in Nuremberg.
He's like, how can you wait? Please don't wait.
This guy, he told this right-wing Cuban guy, Rick Sanchez, once he ran down a homeless man and ragged it good after a few cocktails, got off. Rick Sanchez, you see him on there? They don't just do right-wing black people, aren't you? They do, right? They got a whole, you know, role of extra right-wing people from different groups on there. But Rick Sanchez was on there. They did a thing called Black in America. Anybody see that? That was entertainment cooked up by John McClane, who told Rick Sanchez that they could make some money on race and homosexuality. Quoted him saying that.
Mm-hmm.
This thing was no different from what they do on CNN every day. Mm-hmm. Mug shots of black guys, you know, rapists, just the whole thing that we get every day. Only they had these African American panels. To sort of turn it off or make it a little dignified. In this Black in America, we had Soledad O'Brien. They used the women to go after the brothers.
Yeah, right.
She was interrogating this black man about why he didn't attend his daughter's birthday. What white people live in corporate media is like a place like Lake Wobegon, where all the guys attend their daughter's birthdays. And they all go to PTA meetings. And then during the primary, after Barack Obama cynically made his Father's Day speech, where he blamed, you know, black men for all domestic problems in the country, they corrected him and called it a sister soldier moment, and they held up Reagan Democrats as a gold standard for how men should behave. Okay, now look at all this stuff. I read studies where they said 90% of white women have talked about if we were in, so that they've seen that they've been beaten up and they've seen their sisters and their daughters brutalized. There was a study came from State University of New York, which said that 90% of white women are shot. And the entry of that was shopping by himself. But then he said she was shot because these women were from middle class homes. Mm-hmm. So I said, after Nicholas Kristof going around, he's one of the feminist progressives on a worldwide tour. Trying to find all the sites that they find, Africa, Asia, Middle East, they come back home and see how, you know, some of these white women. So that today, she's a point person for doing stuff. Some of that, I was watching novels, she said, isn't it wonderful we got Obama? See, all the race, you know, both race period.
Right.
Nobody told her to that cop and shot that. You need to get the memo of that. Kid, we're in a post race period. And she said that Obama is going to inspire a black kid and whose parents in Harlem may be on crack.
Oh.
She said that, okay? Mm-hmm. There was a statistic that came out of the New York Times 2 or 3 weeks ago that talked about soaring crack and cocaine use among white kids. While cocaine and crack use has leveled off among black kids, it is leading to overdoses, emergency room admissions, and as a matter of fact, in Texas, they have something called cheese heroin, where these middle-class white kids are overdosing and on cheese, something called cheese heroin. It comes up from Mexico. I don't know what it's strange concoction. That only merits like a crawl on CNN. So, I mean, this is very dangerous where they impute all the domestic problems to African Americans.
Very, very,
and
very.
And they give them like it's a hoax, it's like a stunt.
And this process, would you say it's fair to say that's because of ratings, that they're ratings driven as well?
Yeah. I think that's what some John Devine's mind. I mean, he made that said that they can make some money off of race.
One of the most explosive and
important ones. Black people defeated, black people were responsible for Proposition 80 passion. Okay. Mm-hmm. You see that big old hoax that the new papers put out? Mm-hmm. And then some scholars from the university came up and said, what's up? They examined it. They stopped and found it. And the answer
falls wrong. One of the most influential and explosive movements in African American art over the last 20 years has been hip hop and its attendant cultures. Hip hop is a vast genre in itself. It's now influenced a lot of serious electronic music. There's all kinds of other genres of dance music and other styles that have been created from it. It has an underground, but it also has a pop field that is making a lot of people a lot of money, mostly music labels. And the most popular hip hop exists as almost a kind of oral pornography. And a lot of the images that are projected from that area of hip hop in another time in America might be better described as a kind of coon show. What is your take on where hip hop has come from and where it's going? I know you were recently in Europe on tour with Conjure, and you said that that was.